absolutely love being a mom. It's been a little over 13 years since Hannah was born, and it just doesn't seem that long ago. Time goes by so swiftly. This is my mother's 15th year in the presence of the Lord. And, you know, every Mother's Day, I think back about particular things that I really don't focus on that much through the year. And one of them is just that she taught me to love God. My father really stressed the importance of memorizing God's word, but she taught me to love it. And I believe there's a difference. You know, we can drill into our children's hearts the word of God. And memorization is vitally important. The psalmist David said, "Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against God." But if all we have is the written word and we don't have him in our hearts, then if we disobey it, our focus is, I broke God's word. I broke his law. If we love him, our focus is, I broke his heart. And I'm so sorry. And there is a big difference. And my mother taught me to love God. And I am so grateful that that was her focus. And in loving him, I love his word. And you know, I truly believe that when God sent Jesus to earth, he expressed his love in our language. He sent him in human form. And I'm so grateful that he did that. The children of Israel, they knew his word. They saw his acts. They did not love him with all of their heart. And we can do that when he lives within our hearts. And as moms, we teach our children so many things. With my children, I focus on, you know, if you drop something, pick it up. It's as simple as that. Don't leave a mess for someone else to clean up. When you get up, make your bed. Put your laundry away. Don't just shove it under the bed so I have to wash it next time around. Put it away. There's all kinds of things that we teach them. But I truly believe the most important thing that we need to focus on is introducing them to their Savior. That he becomes personal to them, their personal friend. And then all the friendships that they have, they'll be focused on, do they love Jesus too? Would they make me a better person in following Christ? Not just, is that the handsomest boy in school? Will he make me look good? Or is that the most beautiful girl that I can go out with? You know, as they grow older and their thought processes change and develop, I want that focus to be on serving him. And then he will help them to find the best friends. Now, I asked Esther if she would like to say the shepherd's song with me, because that's how we close every day. And all week long, she's waffled on that. Sure, I'll do that, Mommy, and then I'd be too scared. So she came up here with me, and the center thing of the pulpit has become a little bed for her. That's not appropriate. So, Esther, you going to say it with Mommy? That I've chosen to share is one that I don't remember a time that I did not know this song. It's called I Found a Friend, and not really a Mother's Day song, but it's my focus as a mother to introduce my children to Christ. It's an old Swedish hymn. It was my grandmother Anderson's favorite song, and I don't know it in Swedish. I don't even know it in Spanish. So I'm going to sing it completely in the language that you all understand, and it is in the Hymns of Glorious Praise. So if you want to sing with me, it's page 473. My heart. Bye. Bye.